Welcome to the third and final Halls of Chaos episode, live at Dragonmeet 2019. This is another small cast, so only group of three, so let's go around, say who you're playing, and a bit about your character. Starting with Belry.
Hello. It's me, Mike. My dad is a ton of fun, but I was on to be a hero, you know? So, here I am! Being a hero.
Just say the record age you refuse for part of this episode. Next we have Adam.
Hello! I've got Denel, who is a half-blood, half-halfling, half-tiefling. So a half-tief. He's small, he's feisty, he's got horns, he likes good fun, and he is armed with a sword and a plush giraffe.
Fantastic. And finally, we have Michael.
A Rastafarian elf, who's very, very sensual, believes in free love to anyone, man, woman, halfling, don't really matter.
Did this come before or after the accent?
Did what did?
The free love bit. Because it works perfectly.
It came before.
It works perfectly.
I had it written down already before I thought about doing the accent.
I love it.
Fantastic. Alright. So, how this game will work, as I explained in previous episodes, it's like basically a door open. You'll have a room in front of you. There will be some sort of passage or problem and or other thing. And it's up to you how you get to the door at the other side, whether it's walk around, walk through, shoot through, explode in a ball of fire. It's entirely up to you based on what you have in front of you. So we will begin with the door going to be opens, and inside is a sort of rickety looking wooden floor. The other end of the wooden, there seems to be this massive door. It seems to be quite slightly bigger than the one you're in the moment, but it looks quite dilapidated. It's held with some massive padlock. And in the rafters, you notice that there seems to be some sort of parrot, which as you sort of look up confused, shouts the word "condemned!" You
did. I've never seen one of them before. It's quite pretty.
This does not look good. Parrot, door lock. I don't know. What the hell is going on?
Is there a parrot talking though?
I thought that's just a parrot too.
Oh, but is he saying something intelligible? Can I speak to the parrot? Hey, parrot.
I don't know. Like, why are you talking to me? Try talking to the parrot.
You
know,
animal handling,
see if you
speak to
the parrot. That's the just like me.
So then what do you think goes first?
Yeah.
So.
You sort of shout it unintelligibly at the parrot for about 5 minutes. The parrot just seems to continually share the word condemned. Can everyone be awareness, please?
I got
natural one. You step forward to try and see the parrot better, and your foot slips on the floor. So sort of crunch the floor all the way. Roll your strength, try and stop yourself falling straight through.
Natural one!
Yeah. Fair enough. Fortunately, you vomit straight through your neck.
Oh!
As fast as death is fast.
Thank you.
So, do you want to be on your own now?
Yep.
What is going on here?
I got a 3 on a 4.
Got a 3 on a 4, okay. You notice that there's a key around the parrot's ankle.
Oh. Hey, there's a key on that parrot's ankle.
Or flaw, or whatever you want to call
it. I don't know, I'm not on to date with my ornithology.
Okay, I can try to shoot it. I got a crossbow, what do you think about that?
Go for it.
Alright, I'm gonna attempt to shoot this parrot that's in our way.
Okay, roll next.
So long.
Let's see, do you shoot my... Yes, you shoot my dead.
I'm just gonna get tight.
Hold on. You shoot Mike through the head, unfortunately, Mike's off. And then collapses dead.
Oh,
on
that's
the floor.
Oh, you know, my mama telling me not to use these sharp things, you know.
On the plus side, there's no one else around you can kill.
Alright, okay. Alright, I've got some iron nails. I'm gonna throw some iron nails at this parrot.
Okay. Roll dexterity.
It's a 2.
Okay. Once more, you also try and stagger forward to try and aim for the parrot. You fall through the hole in the floor. Roll strength, stop yourself from dying.
Five.
Okay. You just managed to stop yourself from dying, like pull yourself back out of the hole, back into the sort of way you just came into the doorway.
Alright, you know what? I'm gonna try and shoot this thing one more time because I had it with this parrot.
Yeah, that's right, roll.
Can't take this number.
Roll the dexterity. Five again. You shoot, the parrot manages to miss and just again flaps closer to you and again just keeps shooting condemned.
I reach out to grab at the key.
Okay, that roll, let's see, dexterity.
11.
11. Yep, you managed to grab the key, starts frantically like clapping at you as you pull the key towards you. What are you going to do now?
I've got a torch. Can I wave my torch at it?
Yep. Roll. 10. Then you smack the parrot up across the head before the parrot is unconscious.
That's right.
You have an unconscious parrot in your hands as you hold the key.
You're saying no. You got to say nothing to me no more than a parrot, huh? Bird. Alright, so I take the key and I go to the door.
Okay. Are you gonna walk gingerly across the floor? Are you gonna walk quickly across the floor?
Actually, no. How big is this parrot? I got some flask. I got a flask on me. Can I put the parrot in the flask?
And should you cram the parrot into the flask?
Alright, I gotta cram the parrot into one of my flasks.
Okay. Parrot in the front of the flask, part of the leg sticking out, which has the key on it.
So I can't take it off then? Keep this attached?
Please attach the parrot leg.
Okay, well I'm keeping it then.
Right.
So I go over to the door and I twist the key.
Okay, I roll the dexterity across the room.
8.
Yep, you managed to cross the room fine. You get the door, unlock the door with your new parrot keyring. You open the door and you just step through. The other two, everything goes white, like bright white light. About 2 or 3 minutes passes as you're walking through the next corridor, you suddenly meet the other two again. And they look at you as if, like,
rascal, where you come from? I saw you dead.
They have no memory of dying.
I've done this wrong. I've been waiting here for ages.
Oh, what is this now?
I mean, I've just been sitting here.
Anyway.
I had an apple.
I would be waiting here. Like,
okay, alright. Well, you know, it's good to see you. I got some backup now. I think we should keep going. What do we see now?
No, this is slow.
Yeah.
Okay. As you do the next sort of door open, opens towards you, and as it opens towards you, a vast wall of bananas just falls to the ground in front of you. The room seems to be full of bananas.
But I don't want to eat that apple.
I'm gonna eat me a banana. Wait, are the bananas ripe?
Yep.
Okay.
They seem to be just past ripe, right? Like still quite edible at the beginning of the ground.
Right, that's just how I like my bananas though.
Wait, is that 10,000 bananas when all you need is a empty room? No bananas.
Okay.
I ate the banana. How does the banana taste?
It's fine. You basically just can't seem to be able to get into the next room for all the bananas that are there blocking the doorway.
I've got a crowbar. Can I crowbar my way through the bananas?
Sure. You basically use a crowbar like a shovel, so it goes bent.
This is pretty impressive.
Yeah, you basically start shoveling like the bananas like a crowbar. They seem to get sort of splitting and ripping and tearing apart. You don't seem to get very far with it.
This is a terrible waste of banana.
That's true.
Also, I'm allergic to kettle.
Try digging with an actual shovel.
Okay.
An actual shovel, just
right. Try to roll spread, dig an actual shovel.
See if I can go higher than
1, 6.
Yeah, you just dig like several few chunks of bananas out of the way. And as you continue to sort of just keep getting more and more bananas.
Have these many bananas. Where are they coming from? Is there a tree? Can I see a banana tree?
You can see light coming from the top part of the middle.
I mean, that's if I look up, does it look like me, like a canopy? No, why not be like a really big banana tree?
Can I climb the bananas?
You can climb the bananas?
Alright, I want to attempt to climb over the bananas.
Right. Roll dice. Yep, you climb up the bananas. You see in front of you what looks like a very large sleeping monkey sleeping in a hammock, snoring quite loudly.
Hey guys, I think you need to come up here and see this.
I mean, I don't want to climb up on bananas when I'm getting rash.
Okay.
Can I come up?
Okay, so you see this gigantic snoring gorilla. What the?
Let's wake that damn monkey.
Maybe it's hungry. I get my crossbow ready.
That's right. I'm going to play a hunger-inspiring little ditty on my banjo.
Okay. Let's roll intelligence on that.
Okie dokie. 5.
Okay. The monkey begins to stir in its sleep. Not awake yet, but it is stirring.
Grab a banana and unpeel it and just kind of waft it under its nose.
Waft it at the monkey?
Yeah.
Okay, let's see what happens. Natural 1. The monkey reaches out, grabs you by the wrist and yanks you forward. Roll dex to not be bitten by a monkey.
8.
8. just managed to avoid being bitten by a monkey. As the teeth come down, you manage to just pull your head back just the extra inch, like, raises the edge of your skin.
I'm gonna want to shoot this monkey now.
Okay.
So, that's Victor. Just... Oh, okay.
Oh, bye. I feel like
there's
a lot going on up there, guys.
Oh, that's
great.
Great.
You shoot. Your shot misses wide and you end up just getting a big skewer full of bananas.
That later.
Hey, don't shoot monkey.
Monkey?
We need that to eat bananas.
I need that monkey. Is there a monkey?
I this monkey.
What are you talking about now? It's too many bananas for this one monkey to eat, so...
I mean, monkeys like bananas. And I'm not eating them. So, I guess... That, why is he eating the bananas?
What's the so the monkey's asleep now.
Oh!
Is this...
Oh! I know! When my mom wanted us to wake up, she'd get two saucepans.
And so I'm gonna start climbing my shield with my... So, alright, well...
That's whatever that's in the set. That's a six.
Six. And you hear the sound of the monkey waking up. Thanks a lot. And the monkey opens his eyes and realizes he's got his grip around your throat. What do you do?
Banana!
Throw animal handling. Yeah, he just takes a giant bite out of your...
Ah! My face!
Your nose is now missing.
Oh no!
That's my favorite nose.
We need head to smell.
No. Oh. And then I got myself into it. Apparently the monkey then won. Oh, no.
Shoot the monkey, shoot the monkey.
Alright, I'm gonna try and shoot the monkey again.
Okay.
Nine.
Nine? Yep, you shoot the monkey through the leg. The monkey is incredibly enraged now. And sort of scars its noseless foe and starts to sort of like charge towards you across the bananas.
I take the power out of the flask and I throw the power at him.
What's the engineering for this?
Six.
Yep, you somehow managed to trick the monkey into running across the weakest pile of bananas and it tumbles through and being buried. And you hear it like underneath the huge pile of like making very angry sounds and then take its way back out.
Yonder.
No, my nose!
Oh, that's not good, man.
I'll be honest, it's not a good look.
I got a torch. I can cauterize that wound if you want me to.
Get that torch out my face.
I mean, good leading there, son.
I'll be fine.
I mean, I get confused all the time. They go after a couple of minutes.
I think this is going to be different.
Okay, so what do we see now where the monkey was?
You hear the monkey still being quite angry, being buried under those bands, but you can see the hammock the monkey was lying in, and you find several bottles of Caribbean rum.
Oh, this is good rum. I open the bottle and I smell it.
Mm-hmm.
Tell you right,
very strong vanilla.
Stop showing off with your smelling.
Oh, I'm sorry, you can't taste this. Ah, you know, it's fine. That means you can drink more of it.
My mum says I'm not allowed to drink.
Why are you here again?
Because I'm going to be an adventurer.
Okay then.
I'm going to be here.
I take one of my flasks.
Yep.
And I fill it full of this good Caribbean rum.
Mm-hmm.
And I make him drink it.
Okay, I should.
You want to be an adventurer or no?
I mean, yeah.
Then you drink this flask of rum.
Rule nature, Dory.
Rule nature.
That's a 4 out of 10.
4 out of 10. He begins to go green.
Oh, I thought you said it was good.
Green is a good look for you.
It's got banana in it.
Green is a good look for you.
So, as the rather sick looking mate begins to sort of run to the way from the where the monkey was, trying to find somewhere to throw up, he manages to barrel through another doorway, leading out of the room.
See, rum solved all the problems. Fix everything.
I mean, it tastes like paint.
That's what makes it good, though.
So as you go ahead through the next room, the door shuts behind you, and then the door in front of you reopens, and instead, in front of you is a very, very cold-looking room. In the middle of the room seems to be a large block of ice. What do you do?
You have some more of that rum left, yeah?
Give me a little bit.
Alright, so I want to pour a little bit of rum on the ice then.
Mm-hmm. The ice begins to slowly melt.
Right, is the only thing in this room is this block of ice?
Yep.
Can I see through the ice or is it opaque?
You see through most of the ice, but in the sort of halfway down it seems sort of opaque and a very sort of oval shape.
Okay.
I mean, I'll be honest, that seems really specific and deliberate and kind of suspicious.
Okay, so since I put the rum on the ice, I
at this point things get suspicious.
And light the rum and pie on top of that.
Okay. The ice begins to melt incredibly quickly as this sort of light blue flame engulfing the sort of ice.
And the aroma of burning rum fills the room.
I vomit.
Yep.
Steam coming off Mike's vomit is just quite impactful.
Should I vomit on the ice?
No.
Why would you do that?
To help it melt.
We don't know what's in that ice, and you may not want to contaminate it with your vomit soap.
We don't know what's in the ice, we don't know what's in his vomit, we don't know what's in him. He wants to be an adventurer, keep talking about his mummy. I'm going to grab the crowbar and just
start whacking it.
Just whack away at the ice a little bit, just to help the burning.
Roll spin.
Oh dear. Six.
Yep, you just keep cracking the hole in the ice. Eventually it gets down to the sort of oval, and as you sort of get into the edge of the oval, you realise that there's a key-shape also made of ice within the ice.
Key-shape made out of ice.
There's a key in there, but it's an ice key.
So we can't melt it?
We don't really want to.
So are we putting out this fire then?
Aye!
Alright, so I see there's a good amount of water under it, so I just kind of I use my crowbar and I swipe the fire off the side.
Roll intelligence to see if you can pull off such a feat.
Clever.
Yep, making it look incredibly effortless and easy, you manage to put all the fire off the egg block onto the board.
That was beautiful.
Thank you. Glad you enjoy something to do alright today.
I just didn't like the one.
It'll grow on you.
I cast blue fire!
Okay, so what we're left with now is we've got the...
You've got a block of ice, basically, the inside block of ice looks like another block of ice that's next issue.
Right, but we're pretty close to that block now.
Yeah.
Okay, so, you know, is the ice still melting just a little bit by itself?
A little bit, yeah.
I'm gonna sit down and I'm gonna wait for the thing to naturally take its course.
Okay. You notice that the more it begins to get to the edge, the more it continues to even melt the T-shaped part.
Is there anything else in this room? Is there another door?
It's just, there's another door out, but that's about it. There's another door out and there's a drop of ice and water. Thick layer of water on the ground there.
Alright, I'd like to go and look at this other door. Can I try it, see if this unlocks what's going on with the door?
Yeah, the door seems to be, it's just that weird sort of lock to it that seems to need quite a large key.
Okay, so I go back to the block of ice because there's water everywhere now, and I push the block so that it's really close right up against the door.
Okay. So you roll awareness, see what happens.
Six.
Six of ten?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. You push the block there, it seems like it could be the right side, but you'd have to remove some of the out edging ice.
Alright, I got a crowbar.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm gonna attempt to chisel it with my crowbar and make it work.
Okay. Perfect.
Ready for a feel of precision too.
Yes. You know, it's all to do with what your hands do, you know. If my hand trying to do, I can do it to 7.
Yep. You manage to chip away a lot of the ice surrounding it, and eventually you have enough ice removed that you can slide this ice key into the lock.
I turn it.
Okay. Roll dexterity to turn the key without breaking it, considering some of it's already melted.
And do you want me to take care of that?
You know, yeah, I think I'm going to let you do that.
Go on. I got little fingers. 19.
Yep. You turn the key, the door opens, and you make your way into the hall.
That was very explicit.
Thanks, lad.
Alright, we're working together. We're making it work, people. We're making it work.
Yeah. As you walk through this small corridor, another door opens in front of you, and it reveals a gigantic sand timer in the middle of the room in front of you. Bottom seems to have a massive, massive full of sand.
Is anything falling through it?
You look at the sand itself and where you are, look at something else in the sand, but you can't see what it is from the room.
Is it heavy?
It looks like some object buried, sort of half buried in the sand from where you are. Mm. Yeah, you're not really close enough to get a good view of what it is.
How big is Sam Thomas at that size of the room?
It's say the room is the size of this room, it's the size of the table. It's about a third of the room.
So if we work together, we can turn it over probably.
Mm-hmm. Good if you want to.
Yeah, sure. Someone must be making a really big egg.
So how do we look at if we're going to work together to turn the sand time?
Okay. Can everyone do awareness, please?
Awareness?
8.
2.
Okay, Mike stands on an obvious pressure switch, but the sound of grinding as this massive sand timer just sort of rotates, it spins up, and the sand begins rushing down through to the other side.
when you do that. Good job, guys.
I didn't. You did.
Right.
Egypt.
Okay, now I'm not so sure that this thing need to be flipped now.
My dad nickname.
You don't know. Something your mother.
Alright, so what else?
There sounds like something very large moving behind one of the walls.
Look for more pressure points to see if there's any more.
Okay, awareness first.
Two.
Nope, you don't see any else. Yeah. You're looking at the ceiling for more better question.
I get my crossbow ready.
Okay. What's Mike doing?
I'm just like kind of impressed by this whole thing turning by itself.
Using all of machinery.
Yeah, like the most complicated thing I've ever seen is like a home. This is like all new.
Holes can be very complicated.
Yeah, like you have to be sure you get it the right way around. Also doesn't go on the ground right.
Angles are very important when dealing with holes.
Yeah.
Holes are very important. Angles are very important.
It was really agricultural implement I could think of off the top of my head. What about rate? That's not
for
agriculture, that's
for
gardening.
Oh. Holes! I thought you were saying holes.
No.
Holes.
Well.
I thought you were talking about holes. Like you gotta get right in the ground or it don't work.
You use the
hole. Yeah, it's like obviously it's hole.
The hole makes a hole, you can then put the children in. And then you have to put the
inside. Why didn't you go jump in a hole? Or figure out this mess.
Because I mean like I don't have a hole. There's no holes, so I can't.
Don't make a hole. There's this thing spinning. Move.
That's not the hole. Yep, perfect hole. Well, all of you were spent perfect hole.
I do too.
So, you trip and you fall and you land in what must be another pressure plate, and the sound timer seems to revolve back around again.
Oh no, I broke it.
Now we're back where we started with the sound timer, basically, okay.
No, the sound that I ran through is now running back through it, because it seems like there's much left to run back through.
Okay, so. Do I still hear? Wait, did I hear anything before?
You heard machinery rising. You hear the sound of machinery moving.
Okay. Trying to figure out if we think it's a better idea for this time to go back the way it was, or to run forward again. What do y'all think about this?
I don't know if the eggs like the timing is all off.
It's tough. I think we'll make it flip all the way again on the other player.
You know, I think that's what we're gonna do, because some change is better than nothing. So, you remember where he stepped before? So I go and I walk over there and I just kind of step around.
Roll awareness, try and find it. I didn't roll engineering. Roll engineering, find the property that makes it.
Two hours.
Just. Two?
No.
You can't seem to find where it was. Mike's looking at you quite confused as he's sort of sitting in the ground on top of the cliff of which.
That does sound like something I do.
I find myself starting to become endeared towards Mike. I feel a sense of protection and protectiveness towards him.
Hey laddie, you found that one, can you go find the other one again? You found it, go find it again, just wandering around and you'll find it by being stupid.
Offer my hand to Mike. I say, hey, no. Come on, up, let's go.
Okay, there you go.
Don't worry, you just be. And I want you to go in that direction there, alright?
Like, just over there.
Just over there and then come back to me.
Roll me a random d20, rolls.
Seven.
He stumbled around to the left, somehow managed to stand in another pressure plate, covered the sand to switch back around again.
Okay, now, come over here. Come, stay right next to me.
No,
just come right next
to
me.
Just stay.
I want him by my side, though.
But it's on the thing.
But once you press it, you just have to stay pressed on it?
Nope. Whenever he steps on one edge,
it activates right here.
Alright. Alright.
Folks, come stand next to me now.
Okay.
Okay, roll the engineering door.
Oh, I have that one. Is that a 7 or a 1?
7.
Okay, I couldn't see from the angle.
Okay. So, if you wander over and accidentally pick up another plate, which spins the sand timer again.
I told you to
get the standstill!
But I definitely saw where he stood before now, so I go and walk over and I step on that plate.
Okay, you step on it again, the sand timer spins one more time.
Alright.
Well, we'll say that. Keep doing this and the thing's gonna break.
Yeah.
It's gonna get confused and break.
Probably know when the egg's done.
Alright. Based on looking at that thing, how long do we estimate it'll take for the sand to come down?
At the moment, it'll probably take, well, so you keep spinning it, not really sure. Judging by how much sand rolled out, it probably looks like it must be like an hour time.
Okay, that's too long. So I take my crowbar and I go and I attempt to smash the top one, because the top one had the thing in it, right?
Yeah.
The top piece of the glass. So that's, is that the string?
Yep, so we've been four of eight.
Yeah.
Yep. Smack the top one with the silver, it creates a very large, deep crack across the glass.
Then keep going, lad.
Nail it. First you don't succeed, I want to try again.
Yep, roll again.
Back. Let's go.
One. It's unfortunate because then you want it stopped on an eight.
You crack the glass one more time. The glass bursts, covering you in sand and pinning you to the ground, burying you under the cloud. At least a bit layer of sand.
Yeah!
I would like to try and rescue my new friend. Can I just try and shovel sand in?
Okay. Let's save all your intelligence.
Oh no.
It's that you don't have.
It is.
Just keep moving. Know your nature.
Oh, I have that one. I'm a farmer boy. That's a 9 out of 10.
You do manage to slowly dig him out using your shield. Eventually his head pops off and he's just buried completely apart from his head.
Oh, God. There you are.
Oh, you saved me.
I
get lost. What are you still farting around up there? Get out. So can I wiggle myself out?
Yeah, you wiggle yourself out. And eventually you find what within the center seems to have been three parts. Looks like a sort of tube. Large metal grate and a hoop. Sort of metal open.
Yes. Sort of a hoop.
Pipe. And that sort of bit of grate just put square.
Is there another door around here?
Yep. There's another door at the end.
Is it got some kind of mechanism on it?
It has quite a large keyhole.
Does the keyhole look like maybe that there's a pipe or or the other thing?
It looks like you can push the grate into it if you want to, yes.
Can we maybe push the grate in and then attach one of the other bits to it to be able to turn it?
You can, yeah.
So high up grate.
Yep. So you spin the bit of key, the door opens with a very satisfying click. And as you leave this area, you have finished all the chaos, part 3. So we will just go around and just say, where can you find these fine people that have been a part of the group this time? So, starting with Michael.
Me?
Yes.
Oh, you can find me to and fro about the on the streets and tube and just standing behind you generally.
Okay.
Next we have Adam.
Hello, Adam. Yeah, you can Twitter at RPG Kitchen and on the intertubes at rpg.kitchen. And that's rpg.kitchen, there's not a .com or anything. Bad choice of domain name, but there you go, rpg.kitchen.
And just sort of kind of mild update, if you've listened to last year's, how's your project getting on?
So my project is to harness the power of role-playing games to help feed the hungry. So I've got a library that people can sign up to, and they get access to a whole bunch of role-playing games. Since last year, there's a few more editions in there. There's about 40 or 50 books. And we've got some Barum in there, and Spyhander, and a few other things, and a load of indie stuff. And sign up for the library, get access to all of it. And we've recently, in the last few months, released merch. Hence the tasteful blue orange hoodie. So we're on Etsy now as well, and we've got a couple of nice designs, one with a glassless cube and one with somebody who is not a beholder, or somebody who is not a Jedi, in the kitchen, cooking food together.
It's a really nice design.
Yeah, it's a really nice design, yeah.
Yeah. Really lucky to work with some very talented artists because I really am not.
So, yep, thank you, Zoe. And finally, Belry, where can I find you?
Hi, Mike. You can find me wherever adventure is. But also, sometimes maybe I'll be selling turnips with my dad. So just look for fine sleeps and we'll get you some turnips.
And on that note, we bring the third and final episode of All the Chaos to a close. Thank you for listening.